Okay, so let's get this out of the way. MidJourney is absolutely amazing at giving us good pictures every single time with good details and good lighting. So why do I think it's bad? Well, think about it this way. I am a photographer, and every time I'm taking a picture, I'm not tossing a coin and seeing what happens. Every time I take a picture, I expect the lights to be in the same place that I've left them in the pictures before. Every time I take a picture, I know what I'm doing because I know the camera. If you're an illustrator, the same happens to you. You know how to hold a brush. You know that your brush strokes are going to be consistent from brush strokes to brush strokes. If you are a creative director, you know that the reference images you're using are always the same and are coherent to the mood that you and the client need. So why doesn't that happen for MidJourney? And why is there a lot of randomness involved? Well, that's because of a single rule mainly, and that is the rule of cool. With every generation we ask MidJourney, MidJourney tries to give us a cool image, a good image. Whereas for me and you, as creatives, we are not guaranteed good results every single time we try to do something. Hell, I'm not even guaranteed a good picture if I don't know how to operate the camera at all. So why is MidJourney guaranteeing us a good picture every single time? That is because it's trained to give us good results. But those aren't the results we need. The results we need, as professionals, are results that can be controlled. And MidJourney is being developed in such a way that is not giving us control at all. Yes, update after update, we got some tools to help us tame the chaos that is inherent to generative AI, but not in the same way that Stable Diffusion is giving us. For example, if I were to think about two tools off the top of my head that are most important in Stable Diffusion generations, ControlNet and IP Adapter, those two tools allow us to do basically anything we want in a way that is really, really close to what we already do in traditional workflows, known AI workflows. Those two tools are basically nowhere to be found in MidJourney. It is a choice that MidJourney is making, and a choice that is absolutely correct for their practice, but it is something that is not good for us creatives, I think. At least, not for us professional creatives. Let's try with a visual example. If me or my client would like a model to strike a pose, a particular pose, we could always show them a reference image. And that reference image, we'd be sure, would strike them as something they would need to do. I could be quite certain that, after a while, the model would understand what I want from them and strike the same pose. With MidJourney, I don't know if I would be able to do that. And that's not because I don't know how to use the tool, it's because there's no way to actually do that consistently. Whereas with Stable Diffusion, we have ControlNet. Within ControlNet, we have Canny, we have LineArt, we have SoftEdge, we have OpenPose. And with all those tools, we can actually influence the results to be 100% consistent every single time. So every single generation I ask Stable Diffusion to generate, they're going to be in the same pose that I'm asking for. This is invaluable both for me, the photographer, and the client, as well as other kinds of creatives out there. Think about it in terms of being a 3D artist or an architect. You want the results generated to be not close enough to your designs or your client's designs. You actually want those designs. So if you were to use MidJourney for that, you would get a close enough environment, a close enough product. But that's not the same as being the exact product, the exact environment, the exact room. With ControlNet and IP Adapter, we could make sure that those same places are the same, those same designs are the same in the final images. Another thing that can be an issue, and doesn't look like an issue at first, is the MidJourney look. Every single MidJourney image has a kind of MidJourney look to it. To those of us who have dwelled in generative AI for quite some time now, it's quite obvious. I would say that no one with some experience in the field wouldn't be able to understand if an image was generated through MidJourney. And for clients, and for people who are neither clients nor professionals, those images have if not the MidJourney look, at least the generated with AI look. Think about it, it has a distinctive look and feel. And it's all about that being good that I was talking about earlier. That's an issue for us professionals in the field, because every single one of us tries to recreate a style that is their own instead of relying on others. The longer this goes on in one's life, the more distinctive their style becomes. But if everything is flattened in that peculiar MidJourney style, then there's no difference between us. And I doubt that we as professionals would want that. We want to achieve either our own style or the client's style, the one that the clients need, or a mix of both. We don't want our styles or that of our clients to be mixed with MidJourney's own, otherwise there would be no difference between us. Ultimately, MidJourney is incredibly easy to use. Yeah, it might be a bit chore to set up at first with Discord and whatnot, but once you get it set up correctly, you can just get good results with a few words. And that's something that cannot be said for Stable Diffusion, for example. But think about when you started and you had to learn how to use Photoshop, you had to learn how to use a camera, you had to learn how to use Illustrator or DaVinci Resolve or whatever. It felt like a lot. You didn't want to go through all of that just to do your creative work. You just wanted to shoot, you just wanted to illustrate, you just wanted to shoot video. But you had to learn all of that in order to grow, in order to get better clients, in order to achieve what before wasn't doable. So the next time you think about Stable Diffusion as something foreign, as something difficult, and something that you really don't want to tackle, think back to those days and realize that it's just another tool, yes, with a steep learning curve at first, but it's not too dissimilar to ones that you already mastered. So yeah, if you want to learn how to install ComfyUI and run your first generations, do I have the right tutorial for you? You can find it here or in the description below. And as always, this is a new channel, so every like and subscribe I get does help a lot. I am Andrea Baioni. You can find me on Instagram at risunobushi or on the web at andreabaioni.com. And if you have any questions or comments about today's theme, please feel free to comment below. And I'll be seeing you next week.